Now let us discuss the question answers of the chapter, The Summer of the Beautiful White Horse. 30-40 words. Answers to be given in 30-40 words. First question is, what made Aram full of nostalgia? What is nostalgia? A feeling when you miss your good old days, when you miss something which you had in the past, now it is no more with you. That is nostalgia, missing good days of past, right? Now, what made Aram feel nostalgic, that is full of nostalgia, remembering his good old days of childhood, made him feel sad. What were the two hallmarks of Garigalanian family? As I told you in the lesson, the two hallmarks of this Garigalanian family were honesty and integrity. Honesty and trust. They were honest and trustworthy. They were poor, but they would never steal. Question 3. Describe the narrators, that is Aaron's feelings when he rode the horse for the first time. When he rode the horse for the first time, he was so excited. He was overjoyed. He was filled with extreme happiness, extreme joy. He had a passion to ride a horse. He loved horses, but because he was poor, he could never fulfill his desire. But Murad gave him a chance to ride the horse. When he rode that white horse, sat behind Murad, the smell of horse was lovely for him. The look of the horse was magnificent. And he was so excited. He said, everything of the horse I liked. So he was overjoyed when he rode the horse for the first time. He was filled with excitement and ecstasy, extreme joy. How are Murad and Aram similar and dissimilar? How are they similar? Both of them belong to the Garigalanian tribe. Both of them are poor. Both of them are crazy about horses. Both of them are fond of horse riding, but both of them cannot fulfill their desire. That is the similarity. Now, how are they dissimilar? Murad is a crazy streak in the family. He is courageous, adventurous. He is a smart and confident boy. He has a way with everything. He can manage anything. He can manage the dogs. He can manage the horses. He can manage the farmers. So he is a smart and a confident child. And he finds out a different way of fulfilling his desire. Whereas Aram is not adventurous, not courageous. He cannot even learn horse riding. So many days Murad gave him the horse to ride. Every day the horse would make him fall. He could never learn horse riding. Whereas Murad was perfect then. That is, they used the horse for so many days and then put it back also. And Aram could not learn riding even after that. But Murad, he learned riding. That is how both of them were different. Now the next is, how does Aram justify Murad's act of stealing the horse? Aram says that if Murad had stolen the horse for selling it, that would be stealing. But now he has stolen it only for fulfilling his desire. He only rides every day and puts it back. So it is not stealing. Next, what kind of a man was Uncle Khosrow? Uncle Khosrow was a big, large man with mustaches. He was a man who would get irritated easily. And rather than speaking, he would roar and he would make everybody quiet with his refrain, with the same words that it is no harm, pay no attention to it. So he was always irritated, but Aram's mother said that he was a nice man by heart. It was only that he was homesick. He had come from his hometown. That is why he was behaving like that. And after some time, he would be all right. That is what Aram's mother said. Next is, how did the narrator's ride prove to be a disaster for him? Now the narrator is Aram. Every day he would ride the horse. The first day when he went for riding, Murad allowed him to sit on the horse and ride. He did not know how to ride, how to start the horse. At this, Murad told him, kick him in the muscles, and the horse jumped and he ran away. So, and after some distance, the horse made him fall and ran away and spoiled somebody's garden, farm. So that is how Aram's ride was disastrous. But every day Aram was given a chance to ride, and every day the horse would make him fall. Next is, who was John Byrow? John Byrow was a farmer whose horse Murad had stolen to fulfill his desire of riding. What was his problem? His problem was that his horse was missing and he was helpless and he was finding very inconvenient without the horse. Question number 9. Why did Murad decide to return the horse to its owner? The day they had an encounter with John Byrow early in the morning, John Byrow saw that it was a white horse and it looked like his own horse. For a second he would believe that it was his horse only, but because he knew the family of these two boys, that they were honest, they could never do any stealing. So Uncle John Byrow, he could never believe that they had stolen his horse. So he concluded, after inspecting, he asked these boys to allow him to inspect the horse. So he inspected the horse from inside his mouth, tooth by tooth it was like his horse, but he concluded that it was the twin of his horse. After this incident, Murad felt that he should return it to its owner, so he decided to return the horse. Then next question is, what did John Byrow notice about his horse in the end? Now when the horse was returned, John Byrow was overjoyed. What he noticed about his horse was that his horse was stronger and better tempered. Stronger because he felt that it had become strong, and better tempered is better in behavior. Now what could be the reason? What could be the reason that this horse every day in the morning was getting its exercise, because Murad would come, steal it and go on a ride on this horse, and this way the horse got its exercise, so it became strong and better tempered, better behavior, because Murad loved the animal, he treated it nicely, that is why the horse became better tempered, better in behavior. So now question number 11 is, describe the boy's encounter with John Byrow. That's how this encounter took place, that early in the morning Aram and Murad were coming back after their ride on the horse, and they met John Byrow. John Byrow face to face, and when John Byrow saw that it was his horse, he could not believe it. He felt that it was his horse because it was white and everything just like his horse. But then he knew that these boys could not do the stealing. They were, their family was known for honesty and truthfulness, so he could not believe that it was stolen. So he asked these boys, what is the name of your horse? Murad said, my heart. He said, lovely name. Then he said, can I inspect it? Can I see it? He said, yes, why not? So he opened the horse's mouth and he checked the horse. Tooth by tooth, it was like his horse. But then he could not believe that it was stolen. It was his horse. So he concluded that it was the twin of his horse and he went away. So after this incident, Murad decided to return the horse. Now, question number 12. Murad had a way with everything. Explain. Now, Murad was a smart child. He was a confident child. And he had a way with everything means he knew how to manage everything. He had a way with the dogs. The dogs did not bark at him. That means he loved animals, and the animals also did not bark at him. So he had a way with the dogs. He had a way with the farmers. When he met John Byrow on the way, he told Aram, he said, you will not do the talking. I will do the talking because I have a way with the farmers. I know how to deal with them. So he had a way with the farmers. Then he said, I have a way with the dogs. I have a way with the horses. Why he had a way with the horse? Because he managed John Byrow's horse so nicely. It became stronger. It was better tempered and he learned riding. So he said, I have a way with the horse. So that way, Murad was a smart child. He had a way with everything. He could manage everything.